barrientos. Erection, Jethro Paredes. Let's call on our starting lineup from our PG, JC, Navy, Sea Lions. Team captain wears jersey number 16, Gregorio Dolor, apprentice seaman. At number 1, Marvin Villanueva. Wearing jersey number 6, Jeffrey Alicando. Number 12, Jimmy Entig. At number 20, Christian Marcelino. And number 24, Owen Jaime Suarez. Head coach now is Petty Officer 2, Leia Ariola. Calling on our Santa Rosa City Lions. Team captain wears jersey number 9, Ezekiel Harvey Quezada. At number 3, Jericho Adahar. Number 5, Henry Sarigil Bakil. Number 6, Axel Van Book. Number 7, Gabriel G. Magsino. Number 14, Mark Kevin Montemayor. Libero is number 15, Aljun Centeno. Head coach, Mr. Edward Jan Uliri.
Here we have the Battle of the Lions, Santa Rosa City versus PGJC Navy. And for the Sea Lions, they begin with Captain Greg Dolor, Christian Marcenino, Owen Suarez, Jemmy Intig, Jepoy Alicando, Marvin Villanueva, and their libero, Brail Tabuklao. The other end for Santa Rosa, Harvey Quezada, Andre Bakil, Jericho Adahar, Axel Book, Gab Magsino, Kevin Montemayor, and Aljun Centeno will begin for the Santa Rosa City Lions. Thank you so much for joining us, folks. This is Mix Gomez at your service alongside Paneng Mercado de Conic Swarter and Ayana Perlas. Paneng mentioned after covering their previous game against Signal, she did see a lot of talent in this very young squad wearing red for today, and they are facing some veterans of PGJC Navy. A quick attack at the middle. Mula kay Jepoy Alicando off of that set by Owen Suarez.
Yes, like what you mentioned, Santa Rosa squad, nag-start ngayon si Montemayor, but before, he's always coming from the bench. And this time naman, itong si coach, talagang sinabak niya na kagad si Montemayor.
And that luck to be a confidence builder para sa kanyang kupunan. The other end, may middle attack naman mula sa kabila, and that is Andre Bakil, who we talked about at the beginning of our coverage as
well. Yes, he was a top scorer for their squad against their game against Signal. And basta maging okay lang ang first ball nitong Santa Rosa, mapapagana nila ang kanilang mga middle attackers.
Right now, gumagana na rin ang atake ni Greg Dolor. It has been a couple of hammers to start this game, Paneng. 100% ang atake ng ating mga manlalaro.
Medyo nagkakapaan pa itong both squads. And slow start that we're seeing here for Santa Rosa squad.
Service ace mula kay Jepoy Alicando. 2 points so far for him. There's that receive that you wanted. Unfortunately, the set was too near. Pero nagawan pa ng paraan ni Kevin Montemayor.
Yes, yan yung gusto natin makita on the side of Santa Rosa. Because sometimes if it was a wild ball or miss set, dun sila nahihirapan ma-convert yung puntos or yung bola into a point.
Right now, it is 2-3. Andre Bakil at the service line. Straight to the libero. Misreceived it. Had to be chased by Owen Suarez. There's the set to Quezada. Itawid. Couple of miscues. Dolor. Tough angle. Ibinalik. Ball kept alive. Longest rally so far. Montemayor's turn. That was close to the net. But he still makes something out of it.
Yes, that set was actually too tight for Montemayor, but he was able to swipe it off the hands of the blocker. Easy point there for the Santa Rosa squad. Look at this replay. Right hand na nga yung ginamit niya. Mapaswipe lang yung bola na yun.
There is a testament as to why he is starting today. Itong si Kevin Montemayor after coming off the bench in the first two matches. Was that a stop? Hindi. Ball outside. Puntos ng PGJC. According to our first referee. But that was reversed by the second referee.
Yes, nakita natin second referee. Siya yung mas malapit dun sa side na yon. And it was not over. There's a good call there by our second referee.
You did see the celebration, the early celebration mula sa Santa Rosa.
Alam na nila eh, na wala talagang block touch on their side.
It is 4-3 right now. Overseed. Pero ganda ng saludo ni Owen Suarez.
Yes, ang ganda lang one-handed set na yon ni Suarez. Minsan ikaw iisipin mo na puntos nyo na yan eh, dahil overball na. But nagawan pa rin yun na paraan ng Navy squad.
That's the new setter of PGJC Navy who came from the Signal HD Spikers last year. Para silang nag-trade ng setters itong Signal at PGJC Navy. While still alive here, Montemayor, he loves that angle. Might have overcooked it, and he did.
Yeah, the ball was too high. I think he was trying to target the fingertips of his blockers.
Last year pa lang, yun yung usapan natin, Paneng. Si Kevin Montemayor, not really one of the most sized attackers in this league. Kaya kailangan mas mautak siya. Parang ganyan sa kanyang mga atake.
Yes, and actually yung...
Uh-oh, it was outside.
It was called outside.
At it's a challenge yan.
Yes, dahil parang kung sa angle natin, makikita natin na mukhang inside, no? Pero iba pa rin yung angle ng first referee.
So this is the first challenge of the match. As we know, may challenge system na po tayo sa ating 2023 Open Conference of the Spikers Turf. Something that we definitely missed last year. So the first challenge will be on the attack of Kevin Montemayor, who we were just talking about, yung kanyang attacking skills. Pasok yan.
Yes, pasok na pasok ang kanyang attack, Montemayor. Like what you mentioned, Montemayor is really not that tall, right? Pero ang taas niyang tumalon and may hang time siya. Kaya naman nakikita niya yung kung saan niyo dadalhin yung bola, yung direction, yung pwesto ng blockers niya. Alam niya paano discardihan yung mga sets sa kanya.
Montemayor is one of the young spikers in the league that got recognition at this stage. Nakakuha na rin siya ng offer mula sa San Beda University. But right now, it is Jemmy Intig who scores on the run.
That was the first running attack that we've seen for this game. And that was a clean running attack. Looking at this replay, na-late pa yung blocker ng Santa Rosa squad.
Yan si Jemmy Intig. Isa na yan sa mga veterano natin dito sa Spikers Turf. 6-5. Pook! Rejected. Kept alive. Good coverage. And it is Kevin Montemayor who will put it away.
Consistent itong start ni Kevin Montemayor. Mapa-drop ball man yan or strong spike. Yung variation niya sa kanyang mga atake is very on point for this set.
What a great start for Kevin Montemayor, who reached double figures in their first game with 16 and 9 in their second one. How about that? Another attack from Jemmy Intig.
Another running attack by Intig. Hindi pa rin naka-abot itong blockers ng Santa Rosa squad. Medyo dyan nahihirapan itong Santa Rosa sa blocking dahil medyo nalilito sila kung saan pupuesto sa mga blockers nila, yung sets ni Suarez. Kumbaga, hindi nila nakukuha kagad yung diskarte sa settings ni Suarez.
Let's see if they will find an answer to that. They have a newcomer in LJ Mendoza who they immediately went to. Now a counter from Navy. Ganda rin ang lagay doon. Beautiful attack by Jepoy Alicando.
As you can see, no, itong Navy talagang pinapagana lahat ng mga attackers nila, especially quick attacks. Kaya naman ito, nakuha nila ang first technical timeout, scoring 8-6 ng Santa Rosa.
Pag drop ball, magsalita na kung si Popua, naiintindihan nyo. Focus na tayo sa block, ha?
O, si Popua, pag Montemayor, establish nyo lang yung block.
Wait lang, Wings. Lalo na sa opener, kapag pag si Montemayor magbablock, establish nyo lang. Kasi malikot mag-ganun si Badigas.
Para sa pag-check nyo lang.
Tama.
Pero ready
lang po.
Sige.
Go, ha?
Libi!
Uya!
Let's go, ate!
Yeah.
You're still watching the Spikers Turf Open Conference 2023 here on One Sports, One Sports Plus, and Smart Livestream. Now, coming from an 11-day break and a much-needed team building are the PGJC Navy Sea Lions. The Sea Lions just arrived this morning from Butuan City, Mindanao, and according to assistant coach Lea Ariola, communication and blocking talaga yung naging problema nila in that first game. With their team building, they were able to have speaking or talking trainings para wala nang hiya-hiya factor on the court, and hopefully we will be able to see them put this into action in today's game. Back to you, Mixin Paneng.
Well, definitely communication and blocking will be key for PGJC Navy against Santa Rosa, because as you mentioned, isa na nga yan sa mga struggles sa Santa Rosa attacking against the tall blockers of their opponents.
Yes, yung mga spikers ng Santa Rosa medyo nahihirapan maka-adjust or makakuha kagad ng mga puntos, lalo na pag naka-establish ng maayos yung mga blockers nila. But this time, medyo nagiging okay yung mga attacks na especially si Montemayor talaga. Hindi siya bothered sa kanyang blockers. Ang ganda ng variation ng kanyang mga attacks. And we're just waiting for the rest of the squad na mag-step up din.
Andre Pakil stepping up once more as he scored the previous point. Combination did not work. Puntos yan for Santa Rosa. Now that's good blocking on the other end for the red shirts.
Yes, ito yung mga nung first part na tong first set is usually one blocker lang for their side. Na-relate yung kanilang middle attackers. So it's really a big help na itong mga middle attackers sa Santa Rosa makatulong sa blockings ng kanilang squad.
Tapos ngayon may pa-service ace pa itong si Axel Boog. You did mention that they want some momentum for themselves. If they do get that, they could be very dangerous.
Yes, kasi every time they get the momentum and ngayon lamang sila by one point, talagang bumubulusok yung kanilang squad eh. Dire-diretso lang sila, not until makadikit yung kalaban nila or lumamang pa, dun sila nagkakaproblema.
Ayan na nga, sagot sa kabila si Christian Marcelino, who seems to be taller than how he looked last year. Definitely yung kumpiyansa niyan, mas mataas pa rin.
Oo, lalo na pag alam nila or naaral nila na maayos yung kanilang mga opponents. Mm-hmm. Talagang tuloy-tuloy lang yung laro nitong mga squads.
There's that blocking na hinihingi ni Coach Lea Ariola sa kanyang koponan. That will give Navy the lead back. There looks to be another challenge. Floor touch ang challenge dito. There you see Coach Edward Lirio. Now taking the reins for Santa Rosa. A new look squad kahit na nakita na natin sila last year. Last year they were headed by Jay Disquitado. Definitely a couple new stars to lead them for 2023. Now, Paneng, if we can go back to that starting lineup change of Kevin Montemayor coming in, hindi naman nagsimula si Yoyong Mendoza para sa Santa Rosa. But we all know what Yoyong can do for the red shirts.
Yes, yun nga. Dahil sometimes yung consistency din nila, kaya sila nagpapalit-palit ng players, itong si Coach Lirio. And napansin nga niya siguro during the previous games, is every time na pinapasok niya si Montemayor, palagi siya nagde-deliver dito sa kanilang squad. So maybe he want to get that momentum as early as now or yung intensity ng kanyang squad na nabibigay ni Montemayor para ma-sustain nila all throughout the game.
We also mentioned that Kevin Montemayor now is playing for San Beda University. He's actually playing with a couple of his teammates there, itong sina Andre Bakil and Axel Boog. Mm-mm. So magkakasama sila ngayon. Still wearing red and white.
Red and white, yes.
That's definitely very interesting how they can develop their game in the Spikers Turf dahil nga nagsiserve pa sila ng residency before they even compete in their collegiate league. Right now, the referees are talking amongst each other as they get ready for this challenge.
I think Coach Lirio yung chino-challenge na dahil may three blockers yung Navy, and maybe there was a floor touch under the net or baka nag-crossing or line.
Well, let's see what the final decision will be. Kakausapin muna ng referees natin. First referee, ang team captain ng Santa Rosa na si Harvey Quezada. And while we're at it, itong kapitan ng Santa Rosa na si Harvey Quezada. He is a former player of the Army. We saw him play in the Champions League kung saan sinabi niya sa atin na natuto talaga siya sa kanilang mga veterano na sina Jailo Labide and PJ Rojas. Alright, so we just got word that there is no angle for the challenge. So we will not be able to perform it.
Yes, and Coach Lirio is now asking, since hindi napakita yung kanilang challenge, dapat dead ball or walang may award na puntos sa Navy squad.
Well, the point was awarded to Navy as Christian Marcelino is now getting ready to serve. But Coach Edward is still talking to our referee. All right, we go back to our action. Christian Marcelino, 11, serving 10 in set number 1. Over receive. Suarez, back row, Marcelino. The call. It goes Navy's way.
Yes, Quesada was saying to Coach Edward that it might be inside, so there was, hindi na nila tinuloy yung challenge because each set, both teams only has 2 challenge each.
There's that set to Quesada who could not answer back. That's another point for Navy.
Yes, ngayon. 3-point advantage na itong Navy.
Ito yung mahirap, no? When things don't go your way, you can't let go. His momentum is now building on the other end for Navy.
Yes, lalo na nakalamang itong side ng Santa Rosa squad kanina.
Set on the other end, Villanueva. That's another point.
That was 4 consecutive points on the side of Navy after that unsuccessful challenge of Coach Edward Lirio. Kaya naman ito, napa-timeout na si Coach Edward to talk to his players and makabawi dito sa set na to.
Mas makaka-atake tayo. Diba? Tapos pala pa yun. Ulit-ulit naman ako iyo. Hindi naman kailangan sobrang lakas na makabalo. Diba? Nandiyan na lang, kita mo na yung kamay. May spiker kayo. Nag-iinsayo naman eh. Diba? Hindi tayo... Ang dahil yung pinag-usapan natin kanina. Kung naiisip nyo yun, gagawin nyo mas maayos.
Go.
Four points ang ahabulin ng Santa Rosa dito sa unang set natin. The Battle of the Lions, PGJC Navy, and Santa Rosa City. Christian Marcelino still at the service line. Ball goes straight to Kevin Montemayor. The quick, that does not go through.
Yes, actually, ang ganda ng intention na yun ni Bakil. Dahil pag pumasok lang yung drop ball niya yun, walang nakapwesto doon on the side ng Navy. Yan siya sabi ni Coach Edward na minsan kulang din ng kanyang squad is yung variation ng kanilang mga attacks.
Now the thing is, if there would be variation, they're gonna have to convert. On the other end now, a service error for Christian Marcelino that finally breaks their momentum. The setter on the other end, Jericho Adahar, will be serving. Straight to the libero. Oh, that was too high. Mistimed by PGJC Navy.
And Bakil was there ready to get that block. Well, let's look at this replay. Medyo napapadami na yung mga one-handed set ni Suarez.
Here we go. On to the open. Oh, Greg Valor. Yan ang utak ng veterano.
Oo, talagang nope. Hindi na kailangan ng power, talagang utak lang. Pa-swipe mo lang sa yung mga blockers. Now looking at this replay, that was a good set actually by Suarez. But anantay na lang niya yung kamay ng mga blockers niya. And Santa Rosa was not ready to get that dig.
And that sends us to our second technical timeout, 4-point lead for Navy. Back inside the Paco Arena in Manila for your Spikers Turf 2023 Open Conference. Service error tayo mula kay Jepoy Alicanto, who is actually off to a good start for PGJC Navy. They still have a three-point cushion here.
Yes, they're still ahead by 3 points, but baka, medyo dumadami na rin itong mga errors ng Navy squad, no? Na medyo pag nagtuloy-tuloy pa yung mga service errors nila, dyan makakakuha ng magandang puntos or momentum itong Santa Rosa squad.
Now, the thing is, their attacking has been on point. Marami rin bigay si Owen Suarez sa kanilang middle hitters, no? Ngayon, si Jemmy Entig naman.
Yes, maybe because they know na yung mga middle blocks or attacks ang nahihirapan na masundan nitong Santa Rosa squad.
Ball still alive here. Great effort from our players. Close to the net. Naibalik na Santa Rosa. Dolor again. Off the blockers.
Ito si Captain Dolor for the Navy squad. Talagang ginagawa lahat para makakuha ng puntos for their team. Mapa-drop ball man yan. Off the blockers. And this time, strong spike naman. Coming off from the left side.
Unfortunately, that is the fourth service error of Navy.
That's the fourth free point na binigay ng Navy sa Santa Rosa.
But they're still up by 4 here. 14 serving 18. Harvey Quezada with the honors. Straight to Marcelino. Suarez tried to dump it. Huay pa rin. Back set. Montemayor. Still alive. Greg Dolor. Oh, what a cross.
Yeah, back-to-back attack there by Greg Dolor. Grabe no, ang ganda ng cross-court attacks niya. Even down the line. Very consistent start here by Greg Dolor.
There's that team captain of PGJC Navy. Coming alive once more. They would describe him as silent as a leader. Pero kapag magalit daw yan, nakakatakot.
Oh.
Yan ang sabi nila. As per his teammates,
ayaw
by the way.
Ayaw natin magalit ang kanilang captain.
Book. Did not go through. Another point for Navy.
Yeah, that was not over. Itong attack ni Book.
Lead is 6 now for the white shirts. 20-14, set 1. Greg Dolor. Ooh, service ace against the libero.
Yes, pinalitan nito ni Coach Edward Lirio si Centeno. De Feria is now inside the court for the Santa Rosa squad.
Balik tayo dito, 21-14, Greg Dolor. Book. Try again. Did that meet the line? Yes, it did.
Yeah, that was Kiambao, rather, who is the libero for the Santa Rosa squad, who is inside the court now.
So, bago na yung libero ngayon ni Coach Edward. Before, it used to be De Feria, as you mentioned. Ooh, what a block! Strongest block of the day so far.
I think that was the first block point itong Santa Rosa.
Papasok na si Yoyong Mendoza as you get to see that strong block.
That was perfect timing sa blocking si Bo.
16, serving 21. Montemayor with 4 points so far. Sakto yan sa linya. What a start for him.
Yeah, sa angle natin, akala natin outside. Pero kahit the slightest touch ng bola sa line, inside yan.
At ngayon, cha-challenge na ang PGJC Navy. The ball is just so fast, sometimes we need a replay to confirm.
Oh, oh.
Let's see. So this will be the first challenge for Navy in this match. Oh, that's in.
That's inside. Saktong-sakto sa linya.
It is a service ace for Kevin Montemayor, who prior to this match had 2 aces in their first match, 1 ace in match number 2 for Santa Rosa. Oh, a service error!
Yeah, yun lang yung sayang. Nakuha ka ng service ace and biglang susundan mo ng service error.
So ang ganda na ng build-up eh.
So parang naging plus-minus tayo sa score.
So it's back to 5, 22-17. Jemmy Entig now at the service line. That goes to Yoyong Mendoza.
back set to Montemayor. Strong attack.
That's from the back row.
Yes, ang ganda ng bawi naman na yun ni Montemayor. Mapa front line or back line. Ang daming puntos na kukuha nito ni Kevin Montemayor. And he's really one of the go-to players for their squad.
Battle at the net. Great read by Owen Suarez. Pakita mo yung walk-off?
Oo. medyo slow motion doon sa walk-off niya yun. Nakita na niya. Look at this replay.
The replay has to include the walk-off. Oh, hindi kita. Sayang.
That was a good drop ball and point there from Suarez.
Lead is 5. The chase, that's low. Mahirap na yung ganun para kay Kevin Montemayor.
Yes, actually, hindi na. Parang pinilit niya yung angle na ma-cross court malayo sa kanya yung bola.
6 set points for Owen Suarez and Navy. Book will set things up. Back to Kevin. Chance here for Navy. Oh, quick. Whoa. Kept alive by Mendoza.
Oy, good save.
Great effort by the players. Set by Villanueva. Bawi, Book. Yes, sir.
That was an easy attack there actually by Book. Hindi siya ganun ka-powerful, pero talagang pinatama niya sa kamay ng kanyang blockers. Now look at this replay. Naka-establish yung blockers na sakto, dalawa in front of him. But yun nga, tinarget na lang niya yung palad ng kanyang blockers.
19 serving 24. Combination.
Oh,
and the combination play. Does
oh, that works.
Yes, that was inside.
As they take the set at 25-19.
Let's take a look at that last play. Some people might have thought it wasn't in. The last second pumasok.
Oh, pumasok ang palo na yon. Kaya naman nakuha nila itong first set by 25-19. Check Mike.
Set number 1 belongs to PGJC Navy, 25-19. What a showing that was for the Navy Sea Lions against Santa Rosa City. We did talk about that attacking prowess of Kevin Montemayor, who had his moments as a starter for Santa Rosa. But then on the other end, beautiful distribution by Owen Suarez. We're seeing attacks from the middle, even from the open, and the opposite para sa PGJC Navy.
This was a good start by the BGJC Navy, led by their team captain, Captain Dolor. He was actually one of the top scorers for that set, together with Alicando. Both of them scored 5 points, but on the side of Santa Rosa, it was mostly Montemayor who scored 6 points. Now we're looking at the statistics. Yung attack points, ang laki ng lamang nitong Navy with 15 big points versus 9 ng Santa Rosa. Yung block points, 2 blocks versus 3 serves, 2 service aces each. But itong ang opponent errors, itong Santa Rosa, they had 6 errors compared to 5 ng Navy. But sobrang dami ng mga attack points ng Navy squad because a lot of them, si Suarez talagang ginagamit niya or ina-activate niya lahat ng mga, lahat ng kanyang mga spikers, especially yung mga middle attackers niya. But on the side naman of Santa Rosa, si Montemayor, mapa front row man or back row, he actually needs more help from his teammates na mag-step up. Lalo na itong second set kung gusto nila makakuha ng panalo.
Well, they did put in Yoyong Mendoza at the end of the first set. Maybe he could be some firepower. But speaking of firepower, how about Jude Garcia making his debut in the Spiker Serve 2023 Open Conference for PGJC Navy. One of our national team players for beach volleyball. Battle at the net. Oh, that's still kept alive. Not anymore. In favor of Navy, who will get the first point.
Yes, no first set, itong Santa Rosa, medyo, may, yung communication nila was actually not that visible or hindi sila ganun kaingay na every time na nagsuscore sila.
That was a net touch by the setter. That's Jason Baldoz. Everybody thought that Mendoza already scored, but as you get to see this one, gumalaw talaga yung net. It was just a question whether it's Baldoz or Marcelino.
Yes, it was Baldoz or Marcelino, but the second referee called the net touch on Baldoz.
Balik tayo, Mendoza. This time it's low.
Yeah, that was, kita mo yung gigil na yon kay Mendoza, yung palo niya. No first attack niya, actually maganda yung cross court. But natawagan naman ng net touch itong si Baldoz. Sinubukan niyang bumawi but it was just too low for him, for his comfort zone sa attack na yon. But this time nakabawi naman si Bakil sa kanyang quick attack.
You think Andre Bakil could be the answer as that number one support attacker para kay Kevin Montemayor?
Yes, actually no first set, he scored 4 points for Santa Rosa, but like what we mentioned nung pre-game, he was actually the top scorer for their squad during their previous game against Signal. So talagang malaki ang potential na madaming matutulong ito ni Bakil for their squad.
Oh, there's the athleticism by Jude Garcia, who unfortunately crossed the line.
And it was also net touch on his side.
But you saw it, Paneng, right in front of us, just how high he can soar.
Oh, and grabe yung hang time din ni Garcia.
Dalawa sila ni Ranran Abdilia, who brought their talents from the beach back to indoor. And they're really showing their athletic prowess. Suarez back sets, Marcelino. Naibalik. Garcia.
Oh!
Welcome back, Jude Garcia.
What a open attack there by Garcia. Kita mo talagang parang huminto siya sa ere, tapos bigla na lang niya pinalo ng malakas down the line. Look at this replay.
My goodness. It's a lot of power right there. It's 4-2 in set number 2. Chance ball. Jude, Owen, Greg, napalakas. Minute touch.
Yeah,
para
was,
sa Santa Rosa.
It was Bakil and Montemayor. Let's look at this replay. Who touched the net? It was Bakil.
That was already a free point for them, supposedly.
Yeah, pero kung sometimes kung ikaw din yung blocker, alam mo ito yung top scorer ng kalaban. Yung may halong gigil na rin yan sa block.
You think Greg Delor knew that all along?
Well, kung yung outside niya napalo?
Mm-hmm.
Well, as a spiker, talagang ma-ano mo yun eh. Ma-feel mo yung pag nasa Eric ka na, na parang, uy, teka, masyado akong maaga.
Oh, I see. Pero ito, mukhang perfect ang timing ni Christian Marcelino.
Yes, ma'am. Yung variation ng attack nito ni Marcelino. Kahit sa back row, ang ganda nung kanyang drop ball, sakto sa gitna nitong Santa Rosa squad. Nagkagulatan na lang sila dun sa back row.
Strong serve. Battle at the net! Greg Delor makes them pay!
And that was a good free ball para kay Delor. Medyo dangerous yan for the side of Santa Rosa, especially if Delor is in front.
Pag ganun ba, iilag ka na lang sa bola at some point?
Minsan di mo na alam paano ka pupuesto eh.
Oh.
Lalo na pag talagang malakas pumalo yung kalaban mo na yun.
It is 3-7 now. Andre Bakil will do the honors at 19 points combined in their first two matches. Andre?
Oh,
that's in.
Good service ace there by Bakil. Good target dahil tinarget niya yung dulo ng court ng Navy squad.
Mali lang hitan siya ni Christian Celis doon, the libero, who did display some great digging and receiving in their first game. 6 digs and 14 receives. Now he gets the first ball. Suarez, back set. Oh, Jude Garcia, this time from the other angle.
First technical timeout for Navy thanks to that opposite attack by Garcia. Ang ganda ng angle niya ng cross court na yon. Open or open cross court, down the line, always works for Garcia.
Kayo mga kasolve niyan, di ba? Kayo mga kasolve niyan. Sinasabi lang namin sa inyo, yung mga pwede niyong gawin. Maliwala naman kayo sa sarili nyo. Diba? Pag naandyan na, huwag na mag-hesitate. Isa pa, isang problema natin. Nag-hesitate kasi kayo eh. Huwag na kayo mag-hesitate. Kung kaya nyo lang kunin, kunin nyo na. Para naman, para wala rin. Wala.
Welcome back to the Spikers Turf Open Conference 2023. Now, Mix and Paneng, like what you guys mentioned, one really big addition to the PGJC Navy Sea Lions team is Jude Garcia, who just started training with them 3 days ago. And ang sabi sa akin ni assistant coach Leah, grabe daw yung atmosphere when Jude arrived. You can definitely see how the players are more confident and are challenged to be better because of him and his caliber as an athlete. Back to you, Mix and Paneng.
How about that? Hindi lang si Jude ang magandang nilalaro. Dahil sa kanyang presensya, maganda na rin ang nilalaro or mas maganda pa ang nilalaro ng kanyang mga kampi.
Yes, ang ganda nitong chemistry nitong squad ng Navy. Well, everything's working for them since the start of this game, no? Ang ganda ng communication nila, yung teamwork nila. And every time na lumalamang yung kalaban, nakakabawi sila kagad. Grabe yung block na yon ni Dolor. I saw it from our angle, Migs. Talagang perfect timing, perfect yung kanyang pagpasok ng kamay. Kaya naman, block point, easy block point for Dolor.
Now, they're just making it really hard for Santa Rosa. You talked about the receive of Santa Rosa needing to be very good here against that serve of Navy.
Yes, there are times that they have a good reception, but there are times naman na nag-over-receive or na-aisan pa sila nitong Navy. But once na makuha nila yung tamang pwesto or mataas lang nila yung bola, magagawa na yun ang paraan ng setter nila.
Hindi. Mali mo. Ayaw mo kasi mag-ayos eh. Isa, ano bang gagawin? Paulit-ulit ako, mag-receive muna tayong maayos. Simulan muna natin. Okay? Tapos mag-set tayo. Magkaroon ka, pahiwa-hiwalin mo muna yung spikers mo para isa lang ang blocker. Sa atake, hindi puro palakas. Gawa lang ng paraan.
Now Santa Rosa is really needing a turnaround for themselves. Paneng mentioned that receive na yun na rin na pinag-usapan ni Coach Edward Lirio. Where will the answer come from here? And now, was that a service ace? Mukhang hindi. At yeah, it's a challenge yan.
Nakita ng ating line judge na it was outside. But there's a challenge na inside yung bola.
PGJC Navy hindi talaga nagtitipid sa kanilang mga challenge ha, for today. Well, of course, why not use it? You do have 2 per set. They are up 11-4. As you mentioned, it seems like things are really going their way since the beginning of this match. At ayan, successful pa.
It's super inside na. That was a good challenge called by Coach Leah.
So that is the service ace mula kay Jepoy Alicando.
Goes to the Philippine Navy.
It's 12-4 now.
So everything's working for the side of Navy. Services, blockings, and attacks. Kaya naman ang laki na ng kanilang lamang for this set.
Miscue right there. Mendoza could not get it through as the set was too early or too high.
It was actually an overball coming off from the first ball ng kanilang libero.
At ngayon, papasok si Erickson Coach Pusa Santelices, who is actually a playing coach for Santa Rosa. Let's see if he can cause some change here for the red shirts. Try to go to the side. That was out.
But they're still in a comfortable lead now. Itong side ng Navy. Kaya naman medyo nag-aano na sila. Nag-experiment na sila na kanila mga targets.
Yoyong Mendoza still hasn't gotten his groove so far. Over receive. Another one-hand save by Suarez. Chance for them. Back row, Marcelino. Chase, no more.
That was a good attempt though for the side of the Santa Rosa squad. But I'm looking at the statistics now ng blocking nitong Navy. They already have four big block points for this set. Yun yung mga sunod-sunod na blocks ni Captain Dolor yung nasa front row siya on the open side.
And remember, dalawa lang yan nung first set para sa Navy. Mas marami pang blocks yung Santa Rosa. What a serve that was. And it ends up as an easy one for Greg Dolor.
Yes, na ngayon itong side ng Santa Rosa, si Santelices, yung kanilang setter ngayon, is in the back row. So medyo mahihirapan siya mag-set kung dikit sa net yung first ball nila.
Another block. Montemayor. Garcia was there. Intake this time is rejected by LJ Mendoza.
That was a good one. Single block there. Saktong-sakto yung kanyang timing.
They definitely needed that one. LJ Mendoza, who is also playing his first game in the Spikers Turf 2023 Open Conference. Here's Montemayor. Down by 9. Suarez, Greg Dolor, set back. This time on the other end. Garcia, what a read. Beautiful attack.
Yeah, grabe. Ganda ng blocking kay Dolor, pero sinet naman sa back row kay Garcia. No one was there to get that defense. Look at this replay. Nice set there by Suarez in the back row. Perfect cross-court by Garcia. Saktong-sakto sa zone 1 ng Santa Rosa.
That will send us to our second technical timeout, 16-6.
Isa-isayin lang natin, huwag tayo mamadali. Okay, isa-isayin lang natin. Kunin muna natin yung first ball. Kailangan lang naman ng first ball eh, pag makaka-attack naman tayo. Ah, go. Malayo pa yan,
boys, kayo again, kayo mga kasold niyan. Kayo nasa loob ng court, binibigyan namin kayo ng option. Diba kung ano mga gagawin niyo?
You're still watching the Spikers Turf Open Conference 2023. This is the PGJC Navy Sea Lions versus the Santa Rosa City Lions here on One Sports. Now, with their past two losses and this first set loss, ang sinabi lang ni Head Coach Ed Lirio to his young squad is to not let the past affect their morale. Head Coach Ed noticed that in their first set, one small minor inconvenience affects them so much, and that should not be the case. They should use these to fuel them to be better and urge them to take these opportunities to prove themselves as young leaders, since leadership is something that still lacks in this young squad. Back to you, Mix and Paneng.
That's the thing. There seems to be some inconveniences for Santa Rosa. The other end, all the conveniences in the world for Navy.
Yeah, sometimes if you're a young squad, medyo parang nafe-feel mo na mabigat sa'yo or for your squad na nalalamangan kayo ng kalaban, nahihirapan kayong makabawi kagad. Especially itong veteran squad, talagang tinitake advantage nila lahat ng mga lamang nila, lahat ng mga puntos nila. Pinapakita talaga nila sa Santa Rosa na kung bakit sila veterano at ganyan maglaro ang mga veterano.
At sa lagay na yan, nadagdagan pa sila ng isang Jude Garcia sa kanilang lineup.
Oo.
That being said, Paneng, This is a new look, PGJC Navy squad. Nawala sina Jacqueline King, Jovin de la Vega, Jao Umandal, but with the likes of Jude Garcia, Christian Marcelino emerging, Owen Suarez is there. Do you think this is one of the contenders that we have?
Especially with the leadership of Greg Dolor, no? Na ang ganda, parang tagal na nilang magkakasama itong Navy squad. Though itong set na to, meron silang 4 service errors na. But they still have a comfortable 10-point lead for this set. So like what you mentioned na nga, ang ganda nitong chemistry and teamwork nitong Navy squad na talaga tuloy-tuloy lang nilang pinapakita.
And there's that chemistry that we have been looking for Santa Rosa on the other end. Yoyong Mendoza gets himself involved. Maneng, 18 years old yan si Yoyong. As you can see, very tall, very athletic. Long way to go for him. And then a service error.
Yeah, yan yung sayang, lalo na pag kayo yung naghahabol. Medyo, yan yung sometimes mabilis makahatak pababa ng yung squad. Now you're trying to get a lot of points or you're trying your best to get points coming off from blocks or attacks. Then kung kailan nasa inyo na yung momentum, nasa service area na kayo, then magiging error pa.
Another point here for Navy. There looks to be another challenge. Nasulit talaga yung challenges for today, ah.
Oo, ito namang Santa Rosa, nagtawag ng net touch challenge.
So we have seen some successful challenges so far. Tingnan natin kung successful ito for Coach Ed Lirio. They would fight for every point at this point as they are down 1-0 and down 10 here in set 2. There's Jude Garcia. First glimpse of him in the Navy uniform for 2023 alongside the likes of Greg Dolor, Christian Marcelino, andyan din si Jepoy Alicando. Owen Suarez, their new setter. The other end, some young studs for Coach Ed Lirio, Kevin Montemayor, Yoyong Mendoza. Kita rin natin si Andre Bakil, who started this game very well. Still waiting for that challenge. All right. Let's see. Meron ba? Meron. Pero pula.
Yeah, I think it's on their side.
Yes.
May net touch.
Unfortunately, they were the one who challenged it.
Yes, and I think parang akala nila is yung blockers ng Navy squad yung
tumama.
Na yung tumama.
Suarez serving 20-9. Run this time.
Yeah, that was a running attack. Sana na sinet for Bakil, but the set was too high. Hindi sila nagkaintindihan doon ng setter.
Suarez again on the serve. Santalises this time to the open.
Oh.
There's the hammer from Yoyong Mendoza.
Magandang bawi yon ni Yoyong Mendoza on the open attack. But nakita mo yung body language nitong Santa Rosa squad na kahit na nakakuha sila ng magandang puntos na yon coming up from the attack of Mendoza, parang hindi sila masyadong nag-celebrate or nag-usap or get a huddle.
They get another point here. Let's see if that celebration will also increase in volume and intensity. They need this momentum right now, down by 10. 11, serving 21. A quick!
Whoa!
Point for Jepoy Alicando.
That was a good, quick attack by Alicando. Grabe, narinig mo yung palo na yun. Ang lutong and grabe yung bounce niya sa floor. Look at this replay.
Bilis ng bawi doon, ng Navy. And then, the fifth service error of the white shirts in this set.
Yeah, medyo madami yun na libreng puntos for Santa Rosa.
Wasn't that their problem as well in the first set?
Yes, madami din silang service error noon.
9 in total now.
Yes, 9 in total. So for this set pa lang, 5 na sila.
Greg Dolor gets 2 blockers. Set back. Pagulong will give it back to their captain. Balik ulit. This time, Garcia's turn. Kept alive. Good rally. Montemayor to Yoyong. Owen looks and sits. Garcia off speed. Buhay pa rin. Oh, that's a tough angle. But great recognition by Yoyong Mendoza to send it out through the blocker.
Ang ganda ng palo na yon ni Yoyong Mendoza. Talagang nilaban na lang niya sa kanyang mga blockers. Look at this replay. Ang ganda ng pwesto actually ni Garcia, but pinalo niya palabas. Sakto tumama sa antena.
13-22. Garcia, papawi. Just like that.
That was a good opposite attack by Garcia. Nung previous set sa kanya ni Owen, medyo malayo sa net eh. Yung dalawang magkasunod na opposite attack niya. But this time, ang ganda ng set ni Suarez. Saktong-sakto lang kay Garcia. Madikit sa net. Kita mo naman yung elevation na yun ni Garcia on that attack.
23-13 now. Alicanto with the help of the net.
Everybody was actually expecting na easy ball na lang yun at tatama sa net. Nag-attempt lang sila to get it but walang tumuloy.
Naging easy ball para sa Navy. 24-13 in set number 2. At yan, mababa na talaga yan.
That was a 6th service error for the side of Navy. Overall, 10 service errors na since the start of this game.
Marami yun, di ba?
Madami yun.
Marami talaga.
Oo, lalo na pag first set, naka-4 sila. Ngayong second set, 6.
Uh-huh. And now, service error on the other end for Yoyong Mendoza. And that will win it for Navy in the second one.
Yeah, libreng puntos yun for the side of Navy, which closed the second set na 25 versus 14 points na tong Santa Rosa.
Twenty-five fourteen, both in favor of BGJC Navy for the first two sets against Santa Rosa. We have seen a lot of challenges, folks, and a lot of attack options as well for Owen Suarez para sa BGJC Navy. Jude Garcia debuting for the white shirts. And you still see the likes of Jemmy and Tig, Greg Dolor, Christian Marcelino. On the other end, Santa Rosa, they have had some answers here and there, and they've also gotten a lot of bonuses from the service line, a lot of service errors from BGJC Navy, but they just couldn't reach 20 points so far.
Yeah, like what you mentioned, BGJC Navy actually had 6 service error for that second set alone. Now we're looking at the statistics. Attack points in Navy, 10 attack points versus 4 in Santa Rosa. Still, nakalamang pa rin sila sa block points with 5 big points versus 1 lang ng Santa Rosa. Service aces, 2 service aces ni Navy and Santa Rosa, 1 isa lang. But yung errors, para patas lang sila nitong 8 points kay Navy, 8 points kay Santa Rosa. But yun na nga, itong 8 points ng Navy, 6 doon, service errors for their squad. And nung second set, we saw Garcia started for the squad. He actually scored 4 points for Navy. And Alicanto, who scored 10 points, Dolor had 9 points for their squad. Medyo consistent itong pinapakita ni Captain Dolor, his variations sa attacks. Talaga nakikita niya yung kanyang mga blockers, mapa-drop ball man yan or strong attack. But on the side of Santa Rosa, Bakil actually had 6 points and Montemayor also had 6 points. So medyo itong mga players na to na Santa Rosa, Montemayor, consistently nakaka-score ng mataas for their squad. And kulang nga lang nung communication and yung momentum for their squad. Ang laki nung lamang ng Navy kanina na parang huminto na maglaro itong Santa Rosa.
And when they would get their points, mabilis din yung counter ng Navy,
oo,
no?
May sagot kagad yung Navy squad.
Suarez had to chase this one. Chance for Santa Rosa. Can they capitalize? Quezada! Team captain was rejected. Another block for Navy.
Yes, Quezada starts now for this set. We didn't see him in action during the second set.
Harvey Quezada used to play for Army, as we mentioned. Learned from the likes of Jailo Labide and PJ Rojas. Can he apply what he learned? Ball still alive. Villanueva back in the game. Rejected by Mendoza though.
That was a good block by Mendoza. Quezada actually was not... he didn't actually attempt to go for the block, no? But Mendoza, tinuloy lang niya yung kanyang single block na yun. Ganda nung kanyang timing.
Villanueva to answer back. Libero could not get to that ball anymore. Marvin Villanueva had 15 points in their opener. He was dubbed as the biggest surprise by Greg Dolor for PGJC Navy coming into this season. Dahil baguhan lang din yan si Marvin, pero ang ganda ng nilalaro para sa kanilang koponan. Service error here for Greg Dolor. So simula na naman, Paneng.
Oo, masyadong maaga ata itong service error na binigay ng Navy.
Back set.
Oh!
Marvin Villanueva exploding once more, this time down the line.
That was a good down-the-line attack by Villanueva. Look at this replay.
What an angle.
Yeah, talagang kahit na late yung middle blocker ng Santa Rosa, usually as a spiker, pag nakita mo late yung middle blocker, cross-court attack eh. Pero pinilit niya sa down-the-line, sobrang ganda naman ng palo na yun.
Sagot dito si Andre Bakil. He's had his moments, just has to be more consistent. Sabi nga ni Paneng, kailangan nila ng momentum on their side. 3 all so far. Harvey Quezada at the line. Team captain serving it. A slide. Yes, that works for Jemmy Entig.
Parang si Entig lang yung nag-running attack for the side of Navy. Actually, for both squads, no? And lahat ng kanya mga slide attack,
gumagana. Oh well, if it's working.
Yeah, tuloy-tuloy lang.
At ngayon, Jude Garcia, mukhang nasilaw ng ilaw dito sa indoor volleyball. Hindi na siya sanay eh. Kasi beach volleyball yung napagkasanayan. Pero ibang silaw naman yun eh.
Ibang silaw naman yun. Pero na, naka-shades naman sila.
Naka-shades, oo nga. Marcelino, straight to the libero. No look yung set na yun. But it's still alive. Back row, Garcia, straight to Paneng Mercado. That means the ball is outside.
Good attack there by Garcia. Ang ganda naman ang bawi niya sa kanyang back row, no? Coming off from a service error. Look at this replay. Grabe yung approach, yung wind up ng kanyang attack.
There you see the athleticism on point for Jude Garcia. Jemmy Entig now serving, 5-4. Book. Marcelino gets it back. Hard one at the approach. Santa Rosa's turn. Book again. Naibalik. Red Shirts will try to capitalize. Oh. Unfortunately, Bakil could not get it through.
Actually, that was the second time that we've seen that error coming off from Bakil. Yung i-drop ball niya sa gilid ng blockers, pero hindi umaabot.
Ganda nga sana ng idea, just could not execute. They tried to ask for a net touch, but they did not challenge anymore. Adahar onto Montemayor, and Tig was there. Suarez will go back to Marcelino. Great coverage, Pook. Ball up, really high.
Oh,
Garcia still able to attack. Montemayor on the other end. Oh, that went down.
Yeah, narinig mo rin na tumama muna sa floor.
Si Marvin Villanueva, sinubukang itago eh.
Medyo kitang-kita siya.
He tried to act cool until the very last second.
Hanggat kaya.
Oo. 5-6. Ooh, oh, miss receive. And that's a service ace for Andre Bakil.
Things are looking good here for the side of Santa Rosa. Score is now tied at 6.
They definitely want this as they have experienced bigger deficits already in this match. Bakil again. Villanueva. Wala nang habol yan. A lot of strength for the product of Cagayan de Oro.
Actually, ang ganda ng timing niya sa back row. Look at this replay. Saktong-sakto sa kamay ng blockers.
Combination. Oh. Kitang-kita mo namang may net touch doon.
Oh, oh.
Tanong lang, sino?
Wala na nga amen dahil obvious na. Na point is now awarded to Santa Rosa.
You know what's funny? Tatakbo sila lahat palayo sa net eh, afterwards. Oh, that was an easy one for the referees.
Yeah, but actually yung attack na yon ni Book is actually outside. Walang touch sa kamay ng blockers na yon, but nauna yung net touch ng blockers. Kaya ito naman nakakuha ng first technical timeout ang Navy, 8 and 7 ng Santa Rosa.
Defense pattern ulit, huwag nating kakalimutan, ha? Huwag tayong papasok ng papasok. Kailangan meron pa yung zone 1 at saka sa zone 5, naintindihan, saka yung kicker sa labas.
Enjoy!
Energy!
Libby!
Hula!
Sa loob ka, Bri?
Lulo.
Welcome to the Spikers Surf Open Conference 2023 live on One Sports, One Sports Plus, and Smart Livestream. Now, it's really the lack of authority for the Santa Rosa City Lions, and head coach Ed Lirio ended the huddle saying that nobody is leading, no one is taking authority, and there is no effort at all. And interestingly enough, leadership is something that the City Lions work on off the court by setting days on who will be handling the dorm and even just the food, because coach Ed Lirio thinks that small things like these can be brought on the court, but it seems like it just isn't translating. Back to you, Mixin Paneng.
Ayun na nga, bata ang kanilang kupunan. Leadership will definitely be a test for them. And you did mention, Paneng, also, yung kanilang level of communication, even the way they celebrate, parang nakukulangan ka pa.
Oo, and if you look at them, parang there are times na medyo nagkakailangan pa sila hanggang ngayon, no? So, medyo yun yung critical for their squad, like what Coach Ed Lirio mentioned din, is who will really step up to become the leader of the squad. It's great to have a lot of leaders inside the court, but sino yung magli-lead sa squad inside and outside the court?
With circumstances like that, a service error, things have just got to hurt. Hindi pa sila nakaka-build ng talagang momentum na ginugusto nila, no, for this game. 9-all our score in set 3. Greg Delor. They go to the quick.
Oh!
Oh, could not be saved anymore by Navy.
Yaman, nagkailangan doon si Suarez. Suarez and si Marcelino. Because that was actually a good defense by Marcelino. Look at this replay. Nataas niya eh. And Tig was there to get the second ball. But yun nga lang, yung third ball.
At some point, kailangan mo nalang mag-ingat. You can't hit each other. Montemayor sent back. What a block.
If Garcia is your blocker, paano mo papalampasin yung palo mo sa kanya, lalo na kung ang taas ng reach niya. Look at this replay.
So, paano nga ba, Panik?
Yun ang sinasabi na nga ng mga coaches natin is yung variation.
Variation.
Na nagagawa ni Montemayor kanina during this first and second game, no? Yung pag nakita niya na unahan siya ng blockers, didiscardahan na lang niya, pa-swipe out niya, or paluin palabas.
Strong serve right there by Marvin Villanueva. Ended up as an ace. Almost another one. The reach by Bakil.
Grabe, buti na lang ito si Bakil. Mataas yung talon at yung hang time because yung set na yon mataas for a quick attacker.
Matangkad din talaga yung setter nila. No?
Matangkad din, right.
Harvey Quezada at the service line. The quick, bilis ng sagot. Just like that, another point for Jemmy Antig. It's 12 serving 11. Navy just not giving up any sort of momentum for Santa Rosa. Garcia now send it in. That's
almost a service ace for Garcia.
Book does not go through. Mababa ang atake.
Yeah, masyado siyang malayo sa net. Usually pag malayo yung spiker sa net, hahabaan mo na lang yung palo mo eh para maiwasan na mag-not over.
Pasok dito si Yoyong Mendoza for Axel Book. Mendoza coming off the bench for the first time in this conference after starting in the first two games. Tatawid ni Montemayor. Suarez back to Jude. Kept alive. Mendoza will get it now. Yes!
Oh, good attack there by Mendoza. Suarez was a bit late for that block kasi nakita mo mahinabol siya na second ball. Hindi pa siya nakapwesto ng maayos.
Good one for Yoyong coming off the bench. Montemayor.
Good first ball.
And Tig. Naabot. Naitawid. Buhay pa rin. Jemmy again. This time the back throw.
That was Intig for the quick attack. Talagang ibabaw sa blockers. Yung kanyang palo na yon. Look at this replay. Naunahan din niya yung kanyang blocker. Pinadaan na lang sa gilid ng braso.
Oh, service error. Another one for Navy. Ilan na for this set? Again, we did see a lot of those in the first two. Overall, 13.
So for this set, siguro mga naka-3 service errors na sila.
That is right. Tatlo sa set na ito. Boom! Oh! What a block!
Good single block by Mendoza.
Ganda nun. And that's against Greg Dolor.
Yes, and ito na nga. Tayo na tayo ng score ng 14. Look at this replay.
Yung mga gusto mo tunog ng bola.
Oo.
Oh, pag naka-block ka.
Solid block eh.
14 all. Santa Rosa standing their ground. That's slow.
Oh, that was... We rarely see this, no? Yung back-to-back block points from Santa Rosa. And alam natin na dito sila medyo nahihirapan kung paano maka-establish ng blocking. But this time, during the third set, mas maganda yung pinapakita nilang blockings and na-establish na nila yung mga middle blockers nilang. Humahabol na talaga sa side blockers.
Now they have the chance to send us to our second technical timeout. Unfortunately, Navy has other plans. Team Captain Greg Dolor answering to the call. Team all now. Suarez serving. Oh, that's out.
That was a fourth.
Yes. 14 in total. That has been the problem all day long for BGJC Navy. 16 to 15 in favor of Santa Rosa. Service errors has been a problem for Navy in this match. They have 14 in total, 4 in this set. They're currently facing a 1-point deficit against Yoyong Mendoza and Santa Rosa. This is the best chance that they have seen so far to try to win a set. Great first ball, Marcelino kept alive. Mendoza on the other end, no check, puntos ang Navy.
Yeah, that was outside for Mendoza. Actually, good intention yun, no? Dahil lahat ng mga defenders nitong Navy squad naka-forward eh. So, walang tao there to get that long ball.
Service Marcelino, straight to Yoyong. Here's Quezada on the combination.
Oh!
Ooh! Everyone thought it was outside.
But when in doubt, get.
Get it. Now, was that in? Yes, it was. LJ Mendoza scores.
Look at this replay. Good first ball by Montemayor. Kaya naman na convert iyon into a quick attack.
Suarez saving that ball again. Villanueva finding the back line.
No one was there to get zone 6 ng Santa Rosa. There was a miscommunication kay Mendoza and kay Centeno.
And now let's go to our courtside reporter Ayana Perlas for a report about Santa Rosa.
Migs and Paneng, another factor to Santa Rosa's performance could actually be that 80% are students and we have 3 working athletes, and inamin sa akin ni Coach Ed that these obligations definitely has an impact to their performance and training scheduling, resulting to 3 training days now compared to their usual 6 times a week. Back to you, Migs and Paneng.
Grabe, layo nun, kalahati. Oo. Agad.
Especially if you're in a team sport, no? Yung trainings yan, minsan nga, yung mga coaches hinihirit pa talaga na 7 times a week.
Wow.
But training 3 times a week is actually hard for your squad.
But then again, iba rin kasi, no? Kapag estudyante yung mga kasama mo, they are student athletes, some have work, you would understand. And that just says a lot about their character. Leading the way is Harvey Quezada, who is actually one of the people who resides in Santa Rosa. And Paneng, as you get to see this attack by Harvey Quezada, may fun fact ako para sa'yo.
Oh, ano yung fun fact
ito
natin?
Ito si Harvey Quezada, apparently, is a model.
Oh!
At siya po ang isa sa mga ginoong Santa Rosa.
Oh, wow!
There you go.
Talaga naman na hindi lang pang volleyball, no?
Oo, may face value pa.
Oo.
Pareho pangaro sila ng agent ni Alden Richards. Eh.
Ah, talaga?
Oo. Biruin mo yun. Balik tayo sa ating action. Another service error.
5th service error for this set. Medyo delikado ang Navy dito dahil patapos na itong 3rd set. And they're ahead by... They already got the 1st and 2nd set.
20. Serving 19. Santa Rosa looking alive. Marcelino kept alive by Quezada. Here's Montemayor. Suarez opens up. Marcelino off of the blocker.
Magandang bawi ito for Marcelino.
Christian Marcelino with all the confidence in the world after the responsibility of his drastically increased with the losses of Jovin de la Vega and Jao Umandal. He scored 17 in their previous outing. And he certainly is still playing very well for Navy. First ball, Montemayor. Mendoza. He checks it out.
Yeah, that touched the hands of the blockers.
21 serving 20. Buhay pa rin ang Santa Rosa as they try to extend this match.
Medyo nakikita mo na yung aggressiveness nitong Santa Rosa, no? Dahil nung first 2 sets, hindi natin ito nakita sa kanila na gusto nilang manalo. But ito, na-feel na nila na kaya nilang manalo. Kaya naman mas maganda yung galaw nila dito.
Walang check ball yan. And they get another point. Santa Rosa up by 2. Tatawag ngayon ng timeout si Coach Lea Ariola.
Isang magandang pasa lang tayo. Well, diskarte ka, Wena. Ikaw yung mag-diskarte dyan. One good pass na tayo, patayin natin to, ha? Kailangan natin bumatay nito. Intindihan? Let's go.
Malayo pa yan. Malapit ang jersey. Malapit ang jersey. Ina.
Ina. Ina. Ina. Ina.
Dibi!
Buya!
Santa Rosa looking alive here. 22-20, down by two sets. Santa Rosa has only won one set so far in this conference, and that was in their opener. Kabila naman, Navy. They've only played one match so far, and that reached five sets in the opening day of this open conference. Balik tayo, Andre Bakil at the line. 22-20. Over receive. Chance for the red shirts. The set to the middle. Oh. Na ibalik. What a block by Greg Delor.
That was actually dapat ano na yun eh. Free ball na yun sa kanila, but ganda naman ng blocking. Timing nito ni Delor. He's actually playing middle now for this set.
What can you say about his transition?
Nung umpisa, medyo nahihirapan siya, no? Dahil coming off from an open attack. Iba yung approach dyan eh. Pati yung blocking mo, iba. But this time naman, naka-adjust na si Delor.
Well, they definitely have the tools to make him play middle.
Oh!
As you get to see the blocking on the other end. And that is by Jericho Adahar.
Blocking is working well for Santa Rosa. I think kahit hindi siya block point, as long as mahawakan nila yung bola, mapabagal nila, madadalian itong side ng Santa Rosa.
23-21, Santa Rosa, 2 points away from getting their first set today. Pagulong on the first ball. Suarez, Marcelino, great attack.
Another miscommunication on the side of Santa Rosa. Again, Mendoza and Centeno, pareho silang nakapuesto sa zone 5. No one was there to get zone 6.
Recognition was there.
Saktong on the other end. Sa gitna.
Kaso pag nakikita mo na, nahihirapan naman sila yung buko eh. Kaya anong gagawin natin? Drop left and right. Isa lang yan ha, isa lang na. Isang putos lang lahat yan. Variation na, variation. Mag-isip. Magsalita lang, magsalita lang ako. Karata! Karata!
Now, these are the moments that we really consider na natetest yung mga bagito dito sa Spiker's Turf.
Oo, kasi kaya naman nilang makasabay sa laro ng mga veterano. It's just that there are times na hindi sila nagtitiwala sa sarili nila na kaya nila. But the moment na ma-feel nila yon, like what we're seeing now on this third set, nag-iiba yung galaw nila yun, yung laro nila.
Jude Garcia. Great effort by the libero. Ball still alive. Garcia soaring again. And he scores.
Now Garcia is in the front row. He's one of the go-to players for the Navy squad. Now we're tied at 23. You have to give credit also to the defense of Santa Rosa. Grabe yung habol na yun ni Centeno to keep that ball alive.
Navy has tied it, folks. 23 all. And they finish this match in three sets. Quezada against two blockers. Buhay pa rin. Villanueva's turn. No more chase. And Marvin will score.
That was a good 2 points coming off first from Garcia and now from Villanueva. Now Navy is up by 1 point. Look at this replay coming off from the opposite attack of Villanueva.
See the celebration from Owen Suarez. Match point.
Isang set. Sabihin mo na anak ko saan ibibigay para kahit paano broken yung ano, yung mga blocker.
Ha? Go.
Head up sa Dasa.
Pasabihin niyo sa akin, boy.
So now Navy will serve. The reception should be at its finest for Santa Rosa.
Yes, and medyo delikado naman on the side of Navy because for this set, they already had 5 service errors. And itong very critical or crucial last part of this set.
Marcelino.
That was a good serve. Oh,
that's
too
close.
Tight.
That's out. Tumama na sa antena.
Yeah, sobra
and Navy
na.
Will win it.
That set was too tight for Quezada. Sobra na yung sa antena. And dikit pa at the same time. Mahirap na adjustan yun ni Quezada. Kaya naman itong ang celebration ng PGJC Navy. Pinaghirapan nila itong set na to. And you have to give credit also to the Santa Rosa squad. They played really well for that third set. Parang all throughout the set, it's either lamang sila or dikit lang yung puntos.
Until the very last time out.
Yes.
No? 3 sets in favor of the Navy Sea Lions.
Test 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Check, check. 1.
Welcome back to the Spikers Turf Open Conference 2023 live on One Sports, One Sports Plus, and Smart Livestream. And you just witnessed a 3-set win by the PGJC Navy Sea Lions. And joining me now is the best player of the game, Greg Delor. Hello, Greg. Congratulations. Now, Greg, kunento sa akin ni Head Coach Cecil Cruzada in your last game na communication talaga yung naging problema sa team nyo this season. And yes, you just came back from Butuan City, Mindanao, dahil nag-team building kayo. So, kamusta naman? Ano yung mga ginawa nyo to kind of improve yung communication nyo, chemistry nyo coming into this game?
Yun, yung sa team building namin, parang nangyari is doon pinag-usapan namin para ano, ang pinaka number one na inano namin is yung enjoyment. So, pag nag-enjoy kami sa court, is doon madadala yung communication, maano na lahat ng bagay na ano. Part ng volleyball skills, doon na namin may lalabas yung totoo na game namin dahil sa enjoyment. Yun yung parang key namin, parang kaya kami nanalo ngayon.
Yes, halatangan na super nag-enjoy kayo in today's game. And syempre, Greg, isa ka sa mga veterano in your team, kasama na rin si Jude Garcia. So, being the veterans of your squad, paano nyo parang imomotivate yung team nyo to kind of sustain that three-set performance in the next games to come?
Yun, doon kami na gano'n. Start sa enjoyment talaga. Sa training pa lang is mag-enjoy na kami sa training para pagdating ng game namin is madala namin. Then, numotivate namin yung bawat isa sa amin para magawa namin yung mga part ng ano ba, part ng isa-isang part namin sa loob ng court. Nasaan yun dyan yung receive, blockings, then yung offense namin. Doon, binigay namin lahat yung best ng bawat isa.
Alright, Greg. Greg, may gusto ka bang batiin?
Binabati ko po yung family ko sa Pangasinan, then sa Zambales, yung asawa ko nanonood ngayon, si Charm, then yung dalawang bata, si Yana and Gab Delor. Then, yung pinapasalamatan ko yung, ano, yung manager namin, si Tita Ping, and yung mga boss po namin sa Philippine Navy, maraming salamat sa suporta. Then, sa mga sumusuporta po sa Philippine Navy na mga fans po namin. Thank you po.
Thank you so much, Greg. This is Greg Delor, our best player of the game. Back to you, Migs and Paneng.
Thank you, Ayana. And you know, Owen Suarez would actually attest to that they really put emphasis into the enjoyment that they have, not only in the games, but also in the practices.
Yes, and kita naman natin, it was actually very evident for Navy squad all throughout the game, no? First set, second set, third set. Tuloy-tuloy talaga yung kanilang enjoyment and then communication. And ang importante is yung bawit. Mm-hmm. Dahil ang dami nating nakitang mga errors on their side, especially on the service department. But nakakabawi naman sila kagad. But there was actually a scare nitong third set, no? Dahil dikit yung laban and nakalamang pa ng malaki itong Santa Rosa squad. But because of the veteran smarts of the Navy squad, nakahabol sila at napanalo pa nila yung third set and definitely taking this game. And we're looking at the set 3 statistics. Attack points, always lamang ang Navy with 16 points actually for this set. And block points, nalamangan pa sila ng Santa Rosa with 4 points and 3 lang inakuha ng Navy. Service aces, same, 1 point each pa din sila. But Navy, ang dami nilang service errors, 9 errors all throughout the set, but 6 dito service errors. Libreng puntos yon for Santa Rosa, and Santa Rosa only got 5 errors for that set. But you have to give credit also for the whole squad, no? Mm-hmm. Dahil hindi nga naging okay yung start nila ng first and second set, but nung third set naman napakita nila kung ano yung kaya nilang gawin.
Definitely very promising for Santa Rosa. On the other end, Navy got their first win of the conference alongside the debut of Jude Garcia. Up next, folks, we have two title contenders, possibly at the start of this conference. The Signal HD Spikers will go up against the City of Imus in the second game of your Spikers Turf Friday. Thank you so much for joining us. Congratulations to the Navy Sea Lions for getting their first victory of the conference. In behalf of my partner, Paneng Mercado de Conic Swarder and Ayana Perlas, my name is Mix Gomez. Dyan lamang kayo and stay tuned for the second game of the Spikers Turf.